are going to explain what we did in the last year in the context of DRAC. DRAC stands by Designing RISC-V based accelerators for next generation computers. This project was carried out along some partners as UPC, CNM, and SIG from Mexico, and over 40 people got involved, so it was huge for us. The main design was based around a core that is called Lagarto. It's a 64-bit RISC-V processor. It has a 5-stage pipeline, it's fully in order, and it's written in Verilog. Along the core, we also need an SoC, and for that we choose low risk. It is open source, and we keep improving it and add some custom pieces of IP as the SPI, the UART, some debug capabilities, and also a performance monitoring unit. So once the design was done, we handed it over to some of the partners, like CNM and UPC, and they did the physical design. So in this animation, you can see the different layers of the chip, and the most important one, the one with the logos. So once the design, the physical design was done, we handed it over to Europractice. They put this design into a multi-project wafer, and that allow us to tape it out without breaking the bank. We choose TSMC 65 nanometers. We submitted on the 15th of May, and the target frequency was 200 megahertz. So after a couple of months, we received the first tray of chips, that is in the left. And on the right, you have a close-up of the die, just to see a size comparison. So we check again that the logos look nice, and they did. So we could start the testing. We test first the clock frequency, the clock divider, and the power consumption. But the important bit started when we received what I have here today. That is the processor and the bring-up board. With the bring-up board, we could test all the hardware functionality of our chip. So we get the bring-up board, the FPGA, and then we connect everything together. The FPGA is used as a memory system, and people was keen to see if we get everything right. So you can see everyone cram in the lab trying to figure out which was the state of the chip. And that is what Cristobal would explain right now.
Okay. As Guillen said, the whole team was eager to know if the chip was alive. And in order to know that, we performed different tests to the chip. As you can see in the picture, on the bottom, we can see the image representing the chip, and on the top, an image representing the FPGA. Why we need an FPGA? In this case, the main reason is because we are using the DDR3 memory provided by the FPGA. The first test that we performed was regarding the Lagarto pipeline, together with the L1 and L2 cache. In order to perform this test, we use the JTAG in order to write a program in the L2 cache, and by using the UART, we printed all the results in a terminal. In this case, we execute around 200 RISC-V ISA tests, and all of these tests pass successfully. Also, we evaluate a performance monitoring unit in order to know some numbers of the performance of the chip. The next test was in charge to evaluate the communication between the FPGA and the chip. In this case, we execute different bare metal applications like matrix multiplication, double sort, and we write these applications on the boot RAM and on the FPGA side, and the core fetch all the data and execute the program, and in the same way, we show the results in the terminal. All of these tests passed successfully. Also, we tested the communication with the memory RAM, and it works properly. The next test was to evaluate the SD card. In this test, basically, we write a text file in the SD card and a program in the boot RAM on the FPGA side. This program basically reads the content of the text file and shows the content in a terminal. This test fails, and we realized that there are a bug in the SPI controller. The next test, and it is work in progress, is the booting of the Linux kernel. We added some extra logic inside the chip in order, if something wrong happens. In this case, we have a bug, then we are able to disable some of the modules, in this case the SD card and the UART, in order to move to the FPGA side and perform this test. Well, what is next? The team is working in two new designs. The first one is an improved in-order core targeting low power and area optimized, and the second is a out-of-order superscalar core targeting high performance and low power. And the main idea is to add any of these cores to the chip, and also we plan to add accelerators along the core. For example, our team is also working on a vector accelerator. However, we know that there are several teams in BSC working on different kind of accelerators, for example, for genomics. And could be nice to add this kind of accelerators to the chip, see how it works in a real system. Also, we plan to add a memory controller in order to remove the need to use the FPGA in order to run the full system. Well, we want to improve our verification methodology, and for sure we want to do more tapeouts. Well, this is a picture that was taken after the celebration launch when we sent to fabricate the chip. And now we are going to show a very short demo of a program which executes a matrix multiplication. Well, we can see the final result. The system, well, the PCB board, and the chip connected to the FPGA. Well, personally, I'm very proud of this, of the achievement of the whole team, and hopefully next year we are going to do many tape outs. Thank you for your attention.